Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
The meeting would have come to order.
Now I'm dead.
No warning.
Sheriff handled this one.
Enough to get you in court.
At this time, Mr. Lashley will have the invocation, please.
Let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we just thank you for all the many blessings you have showered down on us. We just ask you to protect all those soldiers that are serving overseas. Just protect them, put your hand of protection over them, and bring them back safe. We also ask for your guidance as we do the people's business tonight. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. For public comments, Pat Bailey, I'm going to call on her first. Are you ready, Pat?
Pat's always ready.
Pat's one
more. I said Pat's always ready.
Yeah. Just pop this peppermint.
Oh. Don't get choked.
Peppermint patty.
Don't get choked.
You didn't share. You didn't share. This one's so sticky.
Oh.
Yeah,
give him something to sweep him up.
Don't mind if I do. Can you take care of my peppermint pie?
This one.
For you people who sit up there, don't often get out in the county, refer to down yonder. Alamance County has a new highway marker.
Oh,
that's
not one of the prettiest in the county. And it's really a bonus for Alamance County because it started in Chatham. And they are. And we've had all kind of hoop molly molly. That's the backside. All right. But anyway. It's a school. It's really about no man's land. It's in that corner of what is we now. Southeast Alamance. Peppermint. Southeast Alamance, Northeast Chatham, and Orange County. And way back, you people didn't give them a bridge, so now they walk across the river, weather permitting. When the water got high, they built a meeting house on this side, so the Baptists couldn't come over there. But anyway, they came over this side for school. And that was way back in the 1700s. And then they try to get a church out of it. And they couldn't. This is on the creek bank, down Lit Creek. And so they went ahead from that, and they kept the church going, and they built a school on up the hill. And the school went on from that little rickety split to a boarding academy that closed down whenever you merged all the schools, consolidation, Eli Whitney went with them, closing down. Well, the church kept on going. This is a Baptist church. 175 years old. It started from down to baptizing. The baptizing hole is still down there. And for you people who don't get off the beaten path, you don't usually somebody from the county comes down and rep when they do something nice like have a highway marker. Somebody shows up and represents the county. So I thought I'd bring the pictures to you. That's a good part of the county. Don't forget them. They're trying to hold on to their community. They're proud of it. They've done great things. Even if they are Baptists, they're still welcome.
Thank you.
So that's the request. Why don't you send them a letter from the county saying you've done good, but because they do have a 175-year record.
And it's Mount Olive.
On a creek bank in Alamance, in Chatham County, and now it's Alamance. The church didn't move, the county line did. We got them.
Thank you. Thank you, Pat.
All right, now see if I can get to this
standard. We didn't know about it.
No, we weren't talking about that tonight.
They got to let us know if they want us to come.
We weren't invited, I don't think. I didn't get enough.
I didn't know anything about it.
I didn't know anything about it.
Well, aren't you glad I brought you history up here?
Thank
history
you.
From down, history from down yonder.
Yes, thank you so much.
Don't forget down yonder.
Okay.
Thank you.
And don't forget my peppermint.
She's an Indian giver.
Okay. that was the only public comment we have signed up. Next, I'll open a public hearing for the closing of a right-of-way for Rolling Road. I'm sorry.
I arrived right as you were opening, if I may speak.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and let him speak. Where is the bill?
Right.
Oh, here. I need you to sign in, please, sir. We have 3 minutes. Okay, this is Christopher Vaughn, and he is, would like to speak on it, and I will let him speak since he was a little bit late getting here.
Thank you. I appreciate your time. I'm here tonight to express my concerns about the option about settling the Orange Alamance County line from last week. Recently, my wife and I have written to express our concerns to the Orange County Board of Commissioners, as well as our state representatives in Orange County. We understand the necessity and importance of resolving the county line dispute. We sympathize with those who have legitimate county line property and or tax disputes. However, the latest version of option 2B3 includes annexing illegitimate Orange County properties that were never originally in dispute. Specifically, we refer to the recent inclusion of the Orange County Park section of Mill Creek subdivision. We are Orange County residents that would be proposed to make us Alamance County residents. We live in the park and don't want to be forced to change our county that we physically and legitimately lie in. What forces are gerrymandering this undisputed Orange County land into Alamance? As stated at the joint BOCC hearing last week, the annexation of the Orange County Mill Creek was done at the recommendation of the Homeowners Board and then also the Mebane City Council, and then, of course, they recommend it to you guys. Arguments presented for gerrymandering the Orange County Mill Creek subdivision are specious at best. They center on the lack of direct county access between the park and the rest of Orange County. If this were a qualification for county line redistricting, then all properties meeting this standard should be changed. Two of the more than half dozen examples are Eliza Lane and Anders Court, both noted in map one for this option. Please note, again, there are more than a half dozen examples. Others exist throughout both Orange and Alamance counties where the only access is from the opposing county. The primary reason for annexing Mill Creek is, flatly put, money. The land developer and the homeowners board and some residents are motivated to move this Orange County land into Alamance for the lower tax rate in hopes that it will increase lot sales and Mill Creek Homeowners Association coffers. Mill Creek has 96 unsold lots, but less than 25 of those are in Orange County. Each of these groups is conspiring to use a political opportunity to usurp the private property rights through eminent domain. But let's call it what it really is, secession. These groups have politically organized to secede from Orange County and have no qualms about forcing legitimate Orange County residents who want to remain in Orange County out with them. If Mill Creek is allowed to secede from Orange County, it'll set a precedent that anyone can change the undisputed county line if they can organize and pay to survey it. Not only will this affect Orange County, it'll impact future dealings with Alamance County too. Approval by the Alamance County Board of Commissioners of this secession hinders the county's ability to control its borders and tax base. What security will there be for residents and economic development along the county line if the county is treated as a line in the sand? I ask, are the county lines for sale? Failure to stop this secession will permit future line changes to any developer or group who want to redraw the line under the precedent you will set in 2009. Please help the county line where it is for the current and future Alamance and Orange County property owners. Thank you for your time and attention.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I ask you a question, please.
Yes, sir.
When you purchased your property, Mill Creek,
yes,
there was no question that you were in Orange County.
None whatsoever.
None at all. Does the school buses come into that development?
Yes, sir.
From Orange County?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How about, have you ever seen Rescue Squad come in and Orange County Sheriff's Departments? And
I have not seen Orange County Sheriff's Department.
Right. But the school buses do clearly go in there for every Orange day. County students.
My children ride them every day.
Okay. You spoke at the meeting about the schools.
I, unfortunately, was not as well prepared then as I am tonight.
Well, that was very good. Thank you.
Okay.
I'd like to...
The next is opening of a public hearing. Just give me a minute. Which is closing of the right-of-way for Rolling Road. Martin.
Madam Chair, Commissioners, good evening. What you have before you, you should have enclosed in your packet a copy of the map, which is highlighted the portion of the right-of-way for Rolling Road should be highlighted in yellow on that, so you can kind of get a visual of what we're talking about. In October of 2009, October 1st, actually, of 2009, Curtis and Clyde Truitt submitted a petition to the Planning Department to close the unopened public right-of-way for Rolling Road. And then, of course, we've adopted a resolution of intent to close pursuant to North Carolina General Statute 153A-241 and set the public hearing for tonight. We have also done all the preparations in accordance with that statute, posted the property twice along the right-of-way, and have notified the affected property owners. And in this case, there are only two property owners that are affected. That's Curtis and Clyde Truitt. Staff did have a little bit of concern if you look at the plat. These were old roads or old lots that were subdivided out back in the 1950s. Closing the road without making any recombination of lots would have created landlocked lots, which basically would have created illegal lots in that subdivision. So I've recommended to them to recombine their lots together so that there would not be any landlocked lots and all of them would have access. Staff believes that this would in no way inhibit or negatively impact any of the affected or surrounding properties with regards to ingress and egress, and so therefore we recommend approval of the request. And with that, I'll be glad to take any questions you have at this time, and also Mr. Clyde Truitt and Curtis Truitt are here also as well.
Any questions?
No, I guess we just, if they've got comments to make on that.
We have to do our questions.
I don't really have any questions.
Is there any confusion? This is a, is there any confusion between the Rolling Road in Burlington and the Rolling Road that we're speaking of here?
No, I haven't had any phone calls or anything, any response to the ads where there was any confusion. So,
how about EMS responding to Rolling Road's address?
Well, because this is not actually built. So it's not, there's no sign up
just
there.
Just raw right land. Or
yeah, it's raw land right now.
Would, Curtis, Clyde, would y'all like to speak on anything?
I get, are y'all opposed to this or are y'all for it or?
For it.
Yeah, that's all we needed to hear.
Does everybody know where this is or do you want them to explain what this is?
I'm fine.
Okay, we're all happy with that. So I have a motion on the floor.
Second.
Have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
No opposed?
There you go.
Okay, the next is a lease agreement for Eli Whitney. Mr. Haygood.
Good evening, Commissioners.
Good evening.
Current lease between Alamance County and Alamance Prone School System for the property of Eli Whitney Recreation Center and the grounds will expire December 31st of this year. We're here tonight to ask that you consider extending that lease agreement until June 30th of 2010. This is a six-month extension on that property.
Have we had any meetings with Eli Whitney to let them know that this is happening?
No. We've been renewing the lease normally for a year at a time for the past several years due to the condition of the property. We continue to struggle with its operating conditions. But at one of the last commissioner meetings where it was removed from the facility improvement plan, there was talk at that time about making some kind of a final decision possibly on the property, and we can certainly do that. I think this extension will get us through the existing youth basketball season, which is the number one program that we have going on down there. And if the board so desires, we would be happy to do that, to tell them, you know, the lease has been extended for 6 months and pending repairs to the building. It probably doesn't have much life
in it. I think we need to let the people in that neighborhood know that's what's getting ready to happen so they won't be in shock and just keep them aware of what is happening.
We can certainly do that and let you, this board know when that meeting's scheduled.
Okay. Any questions? Do I hear a motion?
I'll make a motion.
A motion?
Second.
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, next thing on our agenda is the settlement of Paradise Club case. Mr. Albright, if you would.
I'll be happy to talk about this.
Talk about this.
This is the case the sheriff brought to us in June, and we've been to court. We got a preliminary injunction. We had a court-ordered settlement conference a couple weeks ago, and we agreed to settle this matter subject to the approval of this commission by equitably adjusting the penalties to cover the sheriff's costs and the attorney's office costs, cost investigation, plus $3,000 in penalties, for a total of $6,136.16. And we'd ask the board to approve this equitable adjustment. Part of the settlement agreement requires them never to open a business like this again. I think the sheriff's aware of it and approves it, and this ends this chapter. And I'd ask for a motion to allow me to enter into this agreement.
Any questions?
Okay.
Motion, a second, all in favor?
Aye.
You got it. Okay. Oops.
I think I'm on this one too, right?
You are. Well, it's the legal department.
This was a pass-through through my department. We closed a conservation easement. Charles Sidner, and used money from the state of North Carolina. The deferred payment from the North Carolina Department of Agriculture was $46,761. They paid it into my budget, and then I paid it out. So it was just a pass-through.
Can you explain that?
We bought a conservation easement. Dr. Sidner agreed to sell us the development rights to his property. And it was about a $300,000 transaction. Most of it's state money.
What that is, Ann, is to put that land into a conservation. I mean, it's part of our agriculture board gets applications for these grant monies. And this is coming through the state
to us.
And then that goes to him as development rights.
Has he still got cattle out there?
Has
he still got cattle?
He is. The goal is to preserve farmland.
And we have several applicants. I've been to that meeting several times, and we have some really good applicants. Of course, state is cutting funding this year, so we may not get as many as we have in the past. But.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Okay, we need a motion on that.
I'll make a motion that we approve that.
I'll second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
No opposed. Okay, County Manager report.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. What you have on your agenda is a resolution that would authorize the City of Burlington to apply for part of the American County Recovery Zone development bonds. If you remember last month, we did approve to identify all of Alamance County as a distressed county and would make us available for all the $5.899 million in bond funding. The City of Burlington has requested that they be allocated $2.899 million of that, and that would leave the county $3 million to apply for as part of our capital facilities plan.
Any questions?
I would like to ask, did we ever check into the tobacco, Golden Leaf?
We have. They're not funding capital projects. They are funding some programs. So we're trying to get with the chamber and look at some different economic programs. But they would not fund capital.
Has our county ever gotten any money from
that? Not that I'm aware of.
Surely we qualify if you apply properly.
Yes, sir.
Okay, do I hear a motion to?
So moved.
Motion?
Second.
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. That's carried. Consent agenda. Does anyone want to pull anything from the consent agenda?
I'd like to get 9C, if I may. Just have a couple of questions.
Okay. Ask the director to arrange these, please.
Real quick, the grant, I remember when we were told about the grant. Can you go back over it real briefly for us,
sure.
The amount and
sure.
How long it's for and so forth?
Sure. This is the Office of Violence Against Women grant, and we wrote it to, and the purpose of it is to fund technological infrastructure for the Family Justice Center. There's a lot of underground wiring that's going to have to take place to connect the Family Justice Center. There's some electronic 50B piece and the Vine system that connects 50B orders electronically with each of our law enforcement so that they have immediate access to those. So we wrote the grant to cover those costs and pick up some of the costs that the county was going to have to incur to run the electronic part, the internet and the things that would be needed at the Family Justice Center. So it was awarded. We received word in September. It's $292,000 during a two-year period. So that's the majority of the grant. About $55,000 for underground wiring to the Family Justice Center. Another $25,000 for internal cabling for computer system, and then the electronic bind system and the 50B to the courthouse so the judge can do electronic interviewing so the victim doesn't have
to. How does that relate to the Washington conference?
To the
okay,
trip.
This is the grantee meeting that's required. So that's on. The funder is the Battered Women's Institute Project, which is part of the Office of Violence Against Women, which is part of the Department of Justice. And so this is a required meeting for new grantees. Are required to attend this mandatory event, an orientation session that covers information about the project development, technical assistance, and grant reporting and collection procedures. And we are required to send two or three people, the person that has general oversight for the project, the project manager, and the director or designee from the domestic violence agency that are partnering on the grant.
None of the money in the grant could be used for travel?
It is. 100% covered.
Oh, it is?
By the grant.
So this money is actually a pass-through money?
It is. Well, they require it, but they fund it.
Okay, I didn't see where that was checked on our form.
Oh, yeah. It says zero county dollars, I hope. Unless it got cut off in the form.
I need glasses. I'm not going to lie to you. But that was my
That's
question.
Why I have mine, Mr.
I think it is at the bottom, OVW.
Funding source is the grant.
Okay.
Yes, it is the grant.
So
100%.
I'm a happy fella. Okay.
Okay.
Anybody got anything else?
At least I was on the right track.
Yes, sir, you were.
I did want to ask the sheriff on one of his.
We're playing. That
would be 92. Required for certification on this point, particular one. This is what Josh Jones and Jeff Doucette. Going to Meridian, Mississippi. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Josh Jones and Jeff, is that Doucette?
Doucette.
Okay. Required for certification, no. If no, please. Is training offered in North Carolina? And it's not marked. It's not checked.
You didn't have it checked.
This training is not offered in North Carolina. What all it cost us is, and I think we'd gone for the commissioner to get a sort of a blanket approval for Meridian, Mississippi previously, is $60 for their meals going down and coming back.
Right.
And it's some of the best training that our officers can get, and it's offered
and
by
you,
the government.
You had that in the others. I just wanted to be sure
right.
And be able to mark this one. That's okay. That's good. Thank you.
Do I hear a motion that we accept the consent agenda?
I'll make a motion. We accept
motion?
It.
Yeah.
In favor?
Aye.
At this time, we will go into closed session. I move that we now go into closed session. Pursuant to North Carolina General Statute Section 143-318, 11A3, in order to preserve the attorney-client privilege, discuss legal issues, and to consult with a county attorney regarding the matter of RS&M Appraisal Services versus Alamance County. Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We'll return.